So here's the SCL002 magnetometer magnetic sensor based security system. Basically, I've got a FGM3 magnetic sensor buried about 100 feet away out near my driveway, close to the road. It's only buried about 1 foot deep. The wire runs into the house, which is this blue Cat5. It goes into this coupling unit, which also interfaces the relays. There's two relays, good to 240 volts and like 80 amp. So you can connect just about any electrical device to those two relays, and they're opto-coupled. The output of that goes to the unit, which is pre-wired along with its power supply. All the wiring goes into a grommet on the back. So your sensor comes in from your driveway, and the other end goes to the unit, which is a wall mount unit. It's right here. It's showing the HUD right now. It's telling me that the system is armed. The internal beeper notifications are on. I've got the relays enabled, and the number of intrusions is zero. You've got a keypad with 4 keys and an LED status light. On the back is a grommet, and that is where your power and your communication Cat5 cable goes in. So this would mount on the wall. Pressing any key, the LCD times out after 2 minutes to save energy. Pressing any key will wake it up, or if there is an intrusion, it'll wake it up. Any event will wake the screen up. So hit a key. Any key will take you into the main menu. So the first section of the menu, you can arm and disarm, turn the beepers off, turn the relays off, and then there's more options. I'll hit more options. And here you can set the timer for the relays, how long they stay on, calibrate your sensor, and then save all of these settings to EEPROM or exit. I'll exit. And so the system is armed right now. If I needed to disarm it, all I would have to do is simply go into the menu, hit one again. Now it's armed. Hit one again, go into the menu. Now it's disarmed. Okay, so say I want to, let's arm it again. Hit one, arm the unit. Let's say we want to just turn off the beeper. We'll still get relays and light visual alerts, but we won't get the beeps. So we'll turn the beeps off. Okay, beeps are off, the system's armed, the relays are on. Let's go back into the menu and let's go to more options. And let's set the time that the relays will stay on if they're tripped. So hit one. If you want to clear it to its default, you hit three, which is 15 seconds. Let's increase that to 45 seconds. So 1 will increment, 2 will decrement, 3 will clear, 4 will accept and enter. Okay, so let's go up to 45 seconds. If you make a mistake, you can just hit clear or you can decrement. So I can go up, down. So we're at 45 seconds, hit enter to accept. Now let's save those settings. More options. Save the settings is option number 3. Save settings to EEPROM, yes or no. 1 is yes. Settings have been written to EEPROM, so if the power goes out or if you have to do a reset, all your savings are set. So if a vehicle were to go by, we would see it pick it up. If a vehicle persists for more than 4 seconds, it will trigger the relays and alert you. You can cancel out of that by pressing any key, and that'll shut it off and put it back into its idle or watchdog mode. So if it does trip and you want to abort it, you just press any key and it'll abort. We'll calibrate the sensor. It just gets a new reference reading. More options. 2 is calibrate sensor. Okay, there it's done. And now what I'll do is, so our system is armed. The beeps are off, the relays are on, and we set our timer to 45 seconds. So what I'll do is I'll reset the unit. I don't have a hole drilled yet for the reset switch. And when it resets, it goes through a, it just turned the relays off and on. I did a relay test. There's your splash screen. As you can see, your unit is armed. Beeper's off, as we just did a power cycle, so it knows, it read all the values from EEPROM and it applied those settings. Let's see if it kept our time. More options. If we go into set our timer, it should already be set at 45 seconds. And it is. So we can decrement that 30 seconds. Accept it, hit enter. And then we'll go back in and save that. Go to more options. Save settings is option 3. Save settings. Write to EEPROM, yes. Settings are saved. This time let's turn the beeper on. Okay, beeper's on. And let's start it out with the system disarmed. So we'll turn the system disarmed off. And we'll turn the relays off. Now we'll go set the save those settings again. More options. Save settings. Yes. So all of our new settings are saved. Should be able to do a reset again. And the amber LED indicates that it is disarmed. Green indicates that it is armed. So that's the reason for the amber LED. It's just telling you that the system is not armed. It flashes red and blue when there's a alert. So let's reset this again. The click was the relays. Splash screen. And there we go. The system is disarmed. The beeper is on. The relays are off. But I prefer it to be on, so let's... Okay, now we're armed, and the relays are on. Now let me save my settings. Okay, so that's it. So if there's an intrusion, if an intrusion persists, if it just goes by once, twice, it will alert you, but it will not turn on the relays and go into tracking mode. If something persists for more than